Yes, which means I love a lot. Like, I like a lot. So, do you like
Baisk?
If you ask something. Like, do you like Japanese? Yes, Baisk, yes. Hi, Baisk, yes.
Baisk,
I
love it. Baisk, yes.
So, onegai shimasu.
Baisk.
And then, dozo.
Dozo.
So the O kind of elongates the O.
Dozo. Dozo.
Dozo is more so used as please, as in, you. Let's say I'm the person that's serving the hamburger, and when I give it to you, I say dozo, which means it's more like here you go, please, like please for you. You know, it's a very formal language. I mean, Japanese is very formal. You'll see the first thing that you see when you get to Japan is. Go ahead.
So, like, if you're saying, please sit down, would you use dozo?
Yep. Say dozo. Exactly. So, it's almost like I hear
please
you go.
So, it's like when you're telling. The other one is when you're asking for something. And the other one.
Yeah, it's more like when you're giving somebody or you're showing some. Let's say you open the door for somebody and you're like, please, there you go.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, dozo. But then only Dashmash is like. Please.
One question.
Go ahead, Rachel.
When you say like onegai shimasu, when you're meeting somebody, that also can mean like please be good to me, right?
Yeah, it's. I mean, it's similar to like yoroshiku onegai shimasu. You know how we learned that saying, like nice to meet you. It's pretty much like a term like yeah, nice to meet you. I look forward to our friendship or our relationship. And it's yeah, like you know, that's good. You actually picked up on that. So the onegai shimasu, yoroshiku onegai shimasu. So it's like a please. Nice to meet you. I look forward to this relationship. Yeah, that's good. You actually picked that up. We never actually thought of that together, but that's good. So. So what do you guys think? We can finish with the dozo, and that can kind of give you a few things to think about, and you guys can practice that during the week. And then next week, I really wanted to just kind of talk to you about what your expectations were and what you guys want to learn, so I'll have a better idea as to kind of how the next 10 weeks will go. But I thought, you know, we'll keep it as themes, but every week, you know, we'll work on our hiragana. You know, we'll start working on, you know, definitely practice your name, how to write your names and stuff like that. Even, like, you can write your friends' names and stuff. Just so you use some katakana, because we aren't going to touch on that much katakana in this class. But with hiragana, we'll start